friends, I'm Marit from Marit Studio, and today I would like to unbox some new goodies with you. But before I start, I would like to invite you to give this video a thumbs up, and I hope you would consider to subscribe to my YouTube channel. It would help me to show my videos to others, and it helps my channel growing. Thank you very much already. So let's start. I have a whole box with stuff that I bought because I really wanted some new stuff. And the first things that I would like to show you are two advent calendars. This one, I have no clue what will be in there besides that there what's on the box, like clear stamps, cutting dies and embellishments. This brand is usually for making cards and stuff. That's usually not what I do, but I'm hoping that anything that's in here I can use for scrapbooking. So this is the first one, and the second one is the one from Art by Marlene. It's the third time she releases an advent calendar. I also have the other two from last year and the year before. And well, this is all like art journaling stuff. I know the way she set it up this year is different than the previous years, because the first year she had all like stamps, and the last day it was a tin where all the stamps could go in. And I know this time she's turning it around and giving you first something you can play with. So I don't know what the first box will be. But maybe it's like an art journal or a paper tag or something, and you can use it to make some art with the products that will follow along. I know she has like every month you can participate in like something like a challenge or something, I'm not sure, but it's all in her Facebook groups, her Facebook group, and we'll see what's in it. I won't open them yet now. I'll leave them sealed. They're both sealed, so I'll wait to the 1st of December. So on to the next goodies. So most of the things that I bought are from Art by Marlene. It's from the new collection, but also some older collections. I have two packets of scrapbook paper. This one is an older one, older series. These are the papers that are in there. I don't think I will use them for scrapbooking, because some of the palettes are a little bit too bold for me for scrapbooking. Or I might use the B-side, which is more like a color or single color and not very busy pattern. And this one's from the Neuro collection, from the Mixed Up collection. And it also has some nice patterns. So these are first things, and I also have bought her paintbrushes. I thought I could use some new paintbrushes to start art journaling again. It has been a while, and I hope some new products and tools will help me inspire and motivate me to do some things again. So she has 3 sets. The first one is like a flat brush, a straight brush, and this one's also a flat brush, but it has an angle. And I also have the filbert brush. So those are all different. There are in 3 sizes, the 12, 18 and 20. I also bought her Brighter Than Bright watercolor set. I also have the metallic one, and I also wanted this one, so this is in my stash now too. Really looking forward to use it. Everything is in a box beside my desk here, and it's all mixed up, so it will be stamps, then maybe some other things, and then stamps again, so we'll see. I bought a few stamp sets. This one is a signature collection with all like basic patterns which you can use for your background. I bought her Alpha stamp, which I like. And there's also another with small stamps with like basic patterns and icons, which you can use. And then from the new collection, I have the flowers. Really love this flower. And also the face-to-face stamp. So here's like a basic face and you can make her own hair. There's already some flowers that can make her hair, but you can also use a lot of other stuff, maybe like these flowers or the icons or whatever you want. So I really like that, so you can create your own face. I also ordered the missing colors that I didn't have yet. Now I have almost all the colors. I think there's only like two colors that I'm missing, and those are greens, and I actually barely use green, so I'll be fine without them. And it's I think it's a waste of money if you buy colors that you're not using, but I'm really looking forward to use those. So now the set's complete. I also have the glitter sets, the special effects acrylic paints. It's like glitter paints, and I know there's like two golds and two silver, so I really want to see what's the difference between them. And I can show you in a future video. Also from her new collections, there. Well, let's start with the Christmas part first. These are the angels, the unprinted angel flags. So it's a small book with all the, it's still closed, so I'll leave it there. Leave it like that. And these are the smaller ones, so you can see the size. It's about the size of your hand. Well, a little bit smaller. Well, I mean the palm of your hand. And this one is quite bigger, quite larger. So I'm thinking of making a string with all with angels on it. Like you can hang it. Well, I'm thinking about hanging it before in front of a wall, but you also can hang it in your room, your living room, or your art space, and or maybe even hang them separately in your Christmas tree. Okay, so there's also stamp sets with them. I bought them too, but they're more down into the box, so I'll show you them later. What's also new in her collection are the die-cut paper tags. There are three different ones. These are the funky ones, and you can see already the shape of the tag. Can open it too, and you can use it as a separate tag, but you also can glue them or tape them together, and you can make like an all your own art journal. This is the fantasy ones, and the last one is the funny ones, the funny tags. Really like those. Oh, I can show you one of the angel stamps already. This is the one which goes with the smaller ones. You can stamp on it. And there's also this one. You can use the text. It will fit right into the tag or into the angel. Then this is from an older collection, Bold and Bright. And these are sticky quotes and colorful elements. So I'm quickly flipping through. So you can see there's like white ones, black ones, colorful ones. Okay. And also some sticky quotes. These are all black and white, or white and black. Quotes. A few like icons and pictures, but mostly quotes. So I'd like to use those in our journal. Let's see. Also from Bold and Bright are those layered text banners, and here you can see the the text or the quotes that are in there, and you can also use them without the text and only use like the outside border to use in your journal. So the pile beside me is growing. I hope it won't fall down. Also from the new mixed up collection are the deco frames. Really looking forward to use those. You can see them here in the middle. I also bought some stuff from other brands. I have a few things over here. I bought a paper pad. It's called a Pieter Post, and a Piet or a Pieter is one of the helping people, the helping friends of Saint Nicholas, and that's something we celebrate here in the Netherlands. It's in the beginning of December, and well, for what most people know is, and we only have Christmas and like exchange gifts. It's the same, only we do it with Saint Nicholas on the 5th of December or somewhere around that. So here is the inside. Most of the colors are really typical, like the yellow and red are really typical for these celebrations, and they're like chocolate letters and things that we eat around that time. So that's there too. I have some, it's a cutting die, Winter Wonderland it's called. There's some houses and some trees, and you can like, I hope you can see, you can mix them up and layer them. So looking forward to use this. Maybe not so much in my art journal, but I would like to use them in scrapbooking or pocket page scrapping. Here's where there's a stamp set, which is also from the same brand as the, well, and as the die and also the design paper. This is more like a winter and Christmas, some text that you can use. I also found that's from another brand, like houses, and here you can see Saint Nicholas on his horse, and here you can see a Pieter, which is who is helping Saint Nicholas bring all the presents around, and here's one too. It's a bit like the elves actually from Santa Claus. So here's from Prompty. These are numbers which you can use for like your December daily. It goes up till 24, I believe. Yeah, I think so. And I was thinking, or maybe make something, or you can also use it for like an advent calendar, because they're all small holes in the top. But you also can use it for your December daily. So to start art journaling again, I thought I would buy myself two new journals. I bought the ones from Art by Marlene, and they're ring bound. I have the smallest size, which is the handy size, and I have the middle size, the medium size one, and it's called the perfect size. And there's also like an artist size, which would be really big. But I would like to start a little bit smaller, which would help me, I think. And for this one, because it's filled with all white paper, and I also bought a package with black paper, and there's also a craft paper one, but I didn't use buy it this time, so maybe another time. I would like to start with black and white first. So the last part, here I have the Angel Ensemble, and this is for the largest angel pad with, and you can make your own angels. You can use those two skirts that over here. There are two types of wings you can use, and four faces, so you can combine and create your own angel. And you can even use other faces, I think, that are not in this stamp set, but from other sets. And if it's not fitting on the paper pad, the angel paper pad, then you can use it like in your art journal. So that one. Then I also bought a new stencil. This is the flower stencil, also from the new Mixed Up collection. And there are more stencils, and I really regret I didn't buy those two, but hey, I still need something for my wish list, so I can buy that another time. So you can't buy everything at once. So really looking forward to use those. And I have already seen a lot of inspiration with this Inny Mini zigzag journal. So it's basically like some tags, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in a row, and you can like zigzag them, and there's all kinds of stuff that you can use, and die cuts to decorate them. So I'm really looking forward to use this, and this is some inspiration and some examples already. And then I know it's quite some new thing. I haven't used it before, this size, a slimline size. And this is a double layer paper pack, so there's a black one and a white one on every page, so you can decorate the white one and then you can take it out of here and you can glue it on the black one. And next one, there's another set. So I would really like to try that. And with this, there are some stencils. There are 3 different sets, and I bought all the 3 sets, and you can combine them. You can first combine the 3 sets, because it's a set of 3. Those 3 together, but you also can mix them up with some other, from the other sets, I think. And this set contains these 3. And you can layer them up on your paper pack. So this is 1 set. I don't know if there's like a number, or this is the first one. Then there's the second one, which is, oh, let's see. This one is Playful Frames. This one is Basic Borders. And that's this one, because there's, yeah, like more basic shapes. And then it's really fun to combine them. And last one is the Artsy Designs. And I really love those words. And this one's nice too. Actually, it looks a bit like the one that I regret I didn't buy, but hey, I have got this one already, so that's really fun. So really looking forward to combine these and use this, and maybe like make a journal with this, or put them in my journal. I don't know yet, so we'll see. And then I bought the die cut paper frames, and I already had a glance at it. So here's the frame, and every frame is 2 times in the paper pad. And the first one is with a colored inside, and you can easily take them out. And this one already has, you can, this inside, the colored one, you can get them out, and you also use it separately in your journal or something else. I think it's combined, it's here, this frame fits perfectly in the perfect size journal. So that's the largest one I bought. And each frame is 2 times in here. And the second one, so I'll show you one. And it's also, you can get the outside frame off. And the inside is white, so you can create your own things in here. And here's not an Another line that you can take out, so you can create directly on here. So I'm really looking forward to that. These are all the frames that are in here. So I'm really liking, really looking forward to use these in my journal. Yeah, I would never thought about this, making this. Yeah, so that's really fun. Then I have collage paper. This is from the collection Out of This World. This is the only thing I have from this collection. And it's all black and white. I really like that, because then you can add your own colors in there. So I'll show you the designs, or maybe it's in the back. Oh, it's in maybe, yeah, also up front, but I'll show you the back. So there's more like flowers, there's scripts, there's like a ledger paper, letters, and also other icons. Okay, I always like black and white, which you can use. So finally, last part is the Golden Oldie XXL collector's book. So I believe this is all, there's two parts. There's double-sided pattern papers, which you can use, and there's also die-cut paper elements, so which you can take out just like the frames. And I believe these are all things that were in previous collections, if I'm right. I think so. And you can use them now in your journal. So the papers are double-sided. And here's all the die cuts, like the chubby ladies, and all things, and you can combine the camping van, the caravan, some artsy stuff. Oh, that would be fun to use. There's a lot of moons, which I like because our daughter's called Luna, and that means moon. All kind of animals and paper dolls. I'm really looking forward to use this. This will actually be a challenge for me because usually when I make artwork, I use stamps and color them so I can make them my own. And these are all pre-colored. And so this is actually Marlene's artwork. So usually when I try to use those, for me it feels a bit difficult. So that will be really a challenge. So let's see. And yeah, I bought a really big pack. So it will be a very good challenge to use this. But I'm looking forward to using all the stuff that I have here, all the like the collage papers and the die cuts and die cut paper packs and stencils, stamps. There's a whole lot of stuff that's over here, and also the paints and the paintbrushes, and let's not forget the art journals and also the advent calendars. So I hope to use some of this stuff in future videos, and I hope to see you soon. If you have any questions, please write them down in the down here below the video, and I'll get back to you as soon as possible. And I hope to see you in the next video. Bye, friends.